Hi there, and welcome to A Beginner's Guide to Giving a Damn About Climate Change. Today, we're going to be looking at how to do something about it without really changing what we do normally. There's never been a better time to give a damn about climate change. Getting into the whole climate change thing can create a feeling of well-being. It can make people who aren't into the scene feel under pressure to change.
I'll sell my car!
And in some cases, it can make you attractive to like-minded members of the opposite.
Hey, nice t-shirt.
Thanks.
And same sex.
Hey, handsome.
Cannonball!
So what is climate change?
Climate change is the increase in the world's overall temperature.
So what? I like the sun.
Well, you won't when the polar ice caps melt, sea levels rise, and flood our coastlines, displacing millions of people.
Oh my God.
So let's look at what, or who, is responsible for climate change.
Freeze! Don't move!
What a stink!
Sorry, I made a mistake.
Idiot!
To begin with, they tried to blame the whole thing on cows. And in one desperate case, monkeys.
Leave us alone!
Look under the paws of the hole!
Those guys were all cleared. Once scientists had ruled out witchcraft and aliens, they began monitoring stuff up in the Arctic Circle. And it was at that point, they made a startling discovery.
Uh-oh.
What's up?
Your fault.
No way.
You bad man.
You bad man.
Let's go.
They discovered that the problem is actually a result of man's recent behavior. Man, that is, all of us guys, has been doing stuff recently that's fueled climate change.
You coming over?
Be there in two.
Now, most of you will be good people.
We are.
And want to do something about it. So we've been working on five small changes that we can all make to our daily routine that can make a difference to climate change.
How could that make a difference? I'm only one guy.
This is the point.
Turn off the water!
One small positive act, multiplied millions of times, can actually make a huge difference. So let's look at some of the things we can all do to help. We call them small positive everyday acts. You can call them stuff that helps out. Here goes. Number one. Don't drive if you don't have to. Cars burn fossil fuels. Bad for the environment. The only thing walking or cycling burns is calories. Good for the physique. If you haven't tried walking before, you'll be surprised how pleasant it is.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, raccoon, check out this move. Can't touch me, can't touch this sweat.
At any point in the journey, you can break into dance. Something that simply isn't possible in a car. Numero duo. If you do have a car, keep your tires fully inflated. This'll give you better mileage, which means you save more money, release less carbon, and look cooler. It's so easy a monkey could do it, as we demonstrate here. Check your tires monthly to avoid embarrassment. Number three, use low-energy light bulbs. This type of bulb uses far less power, which means utilities burn less fossil fuels. Better still, make love more, which is better with no light on at all. Take it away, Juanita. Number four, get into recycling. Don't just dump all your garbage in together. Take the time to separate it out. It only takes 30 seconds, as these foxes will demonstrate now. Also, recycled products use far less energy to make than completely new ones, and are just as good. Nice skills, guys. And number five, act global, shop local. Next time you're at the supermarket, take a moment to think about what you're putting in your basket. Quite often, we buy things that have traveled by plane from the other side of the world, burning fossil fuels the entire trip. This is not necessary, and definitely not cool.
Howdy.
Hey, how you doing?
Instead, check out your local farmers' markets. It's always a good experience. You'll find fantastic, locally grown produce that hasn't traveled halfway around the world.
Hey, I've seen you before. You want to come to party?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Invite the customers.
Make friends with these farmer guys. You never know. They may ask you along to one of their famous barn dances. Well, thanks for your time. We hope you now care a little bit more about the issue of global warming and recognize how important it is to our future and can help out by making these small changes part of your daily life. You know, we're incredibly powerful, each and every one of us. Together, we hold the future of the planet in our hands. The truth is, only we can save ourselves.
City.